Good morning everyone. Today we will talk about another very important group of compound, that is acid. Okay, the term acid is derived from Latin word acidus, meaning sour or having very sharp taste. Vinegar contain acetic acid, citrus fruit contain citric acid, tomatoes oxalic acid. Very long list is there. So here we should discuss how to define and how to classify acid. This is today's topic. Okay, so let's start with definition. An acid is a compound which on dissolution in water furnishes hydrogen ion as the only positively charged ion. Like hydrogen chloride, when dissolved in water it will form hydrogen ion plus chloride ion. Okay, but hydrogen ion is unstable to exist independently. Therefore, it combines with water to form hydronium ion. Is it clear? What are acids? Acids are those compounds which, when dissolved in water, releases hydrogen ion as the only positively charged ion. Hydrogen ion is unstable. So, what it will do? It will quickly combine with water with the help of which bond? Coordinate bond to form hydronium ion. Okay, so this is the definition of acid. In term of hydronium ion also you can define. Acids are those compounds which when dissolved in water furnishes hydronium ion as the only positively charged ion. Okay, all acid contain replaceable hydrogen atom that can be replaced by metallic radical or ammonium radical. All acid contain replaceable or ionizable hydrogen atom that can be replaced by metallic radical or ammonium radical. Ammonium radical is also electropositive radical. So now classification. Okay, there are different criteria on which acid can be classified. So number one, on the basis of source of origin. Okay, acids are from where they are derived. We can classify acid into two categories, organic and inorganic acid. So first, what are inorganic acid? Inorganic acids are derived from minerals. That is why they are also known as mineral acid, such as hydrogen chloride, nitric acid, carbonic acid, phosphoric acid. Okay, they are highly corrosive in nature, except carbonic acid. Okay, so this is clear. What are inorganic acids or mineral acid? Which are derived from minerals. Then organic acid. Organic acid derived from living organism. Okay, they are non-corrosive. And non-corrosive are very weak corrosive also sometimes. Okay, and they are weak acid. So mostly they are derived from plant, organic. Okay, any living organisms, but mostly they are derived from plant. Okay, so this is the first classification. Then second one, on the basis of strength. Again, acid can be classified into two. Strong acid and weak acid. Okay, this is second criteria on the basis of strength. Strength of an acid depends upon the concentration of hydronium ion present in its aqueous solution. Okay, higher the concentration of hydronium ion, greater is the strength of the acid. Like all mineral acid except carbonic acid, they are strong acid. They nearly completely ionized in water to form high concentration of hydronium ion. Okay, like hydrochloric acid, nitric acid, sulfuric acid, all are very strong acid. Then weak acid. Weak acid undergoes partial ionization to produce low concentration of hydronium ion. Okay, they don't undergo complete ionization like strong acid. They undergo partial ionization to produce low concentration of hydronium ion. All organic acids are weak acid, including carbonic acid, mineral acid. Okay, so what is the difference between strong acid and weak acid? Strength depend upon degree of ionization. higher is the degree of ionization, it will be strong acid. Lower is the degree of ionization, it will be weak acid. Okay, concentration of hydronium ion is more in strong acid, concentration of hydronium ion is less in weak acid. Okay, then third criteria, on the basis of basicity of acid. Okay, so first you should know what is basicity of an acid. Basicity is the number of hydronium ion produced by one molecule of an acid when dissolved in water is known as basicity of an acid. So on third criteria, on the basis of basicity of acid, acid again can be divided into monobasic acid, dibasic acid, tribasic acid. So what is monobasic acid? Okay, monobasic acids are those acid which when dissolved in water will form only one hydronium ion. Okay, ionization will be completed in one step only. Take example, hydrogen chloride. Hydrogen chloride dissolve in water to form hydronium ion and chloride ion. Okay, it contain only one replaceable hydrogen, that is replaced to form hydronium ion and chloride ion. Clear? Another example we can take of acetic acid. Just see, acetic acid contain four hydrogen but only one is replaceable. Acetic acid is also monobasic acid, though it contain four hydrogen atom, but out of four only one is replaceable. So acetic acid dissolve in water to form only one hydronium ion plus acetate ion. So acetic acid is also which type of acid? Monobasic acid. Okay, then dibasic acid. Dibasic acid contain two replaceable hydrogen like sulfuric acid, carbonic acid, sulfurous acid. They are dibasic acid because when they dissolve in water they will produce two hydronium ion, and ionization will be completed in two step. Okay, first take example, sulfuric acid dissolve in water to form one hydronium ion plus hydrogen sulfate ion. Then second step, hydrogen sulfate ion again dissolve in water to form another hydronium ion plus sulfate ion. So ionization completed in two step. Okay, so they are known as dibasic acid. Then third category, that is tribasic acid. Tribasic acid contain three replaceable hydrogen ion. When they dissolve in water they will produce how many hydronium ion? Three. And their ionization will be completed in three step. Take example of phosphoric acid. Phosphoric acid first dissolve in water to form one hydronium ion plus dihydrogen phosphate. Okay, this is first step. Second step, this dihydrogen phosphate again dissolve in water to release one more hydronium ion plus hydrogen phosphate. Then third step, still one replaceable hydrogen is there. So this third step, hydrogen phosphate dissolve in water to form third hydronium ion plus phosphate. So here ionization completed in how many steps? Three steps. So according to basicity, acid again we divided into three: monobasic acid, dibasic acid and tribasic acid. Okay, then here one thing more you should remember, that monobasic acid when react with bases they will give only normal salt. Okay, like NaOH react with HCl, which type of salt is formed? Normal salt, NaCl. Okay, so monobasic acid always will give only one type of salt, that is normal salt. But dibasic and tribasic, they contain more replaceable hydrogen, so they will give normal salt plus acid salt. Like take example of sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide react with sulfuric acid, it can give sodium hydrogen sulfate plus water, and another reaction same can it can give sodium sulfate and water. So sodium hydrogen sulfate is acid salt and sodium sulfate is normal salt. So dibasic and tribasic can give normal as well as acid salt, but monobasic acid will only give which type of salt? Normal salt. Okay, and one thing you should remember, that concentration and strength of an acid are two different things. Concentration refers to the amount of acid present in a definite amount of it in aqueous solution, whereas strength refers to hydronium ion concentration produced due to ionization of acid. Okay, so a strong acid will remain strong even in dilute solution also, and weak acid will remain weak even in concentrated solution. Okay, so that's it.